Hi there, this is the World Best Supercar Channel, and for some of you who've been watching my recent videos, I've been talking about how my dad was going to be buying the new BMW 4 Series, and he just got it today. I have to. Yeah, so he picked it up from the showroom, and we're driving it back. And we bumped into my dad's friend in his M3. I got a little video of that for you. I'll show you. So basically, this is just going to be a review today on the new 4 Series. So first of all, my dad got, as an option, he got these wheels, which I thought were really nice, and he also got the M Sport kit, which means it's labelled everywhere with M Sport. Then you've got M Sport on the wheels there. Then you got M Sport, where else is the M Sport? Everywhere in the car, again on that side. And then the M Sport kit. Then it's noticeable, but the back, so a bit more aggressive with the back bumper. And then small side skirts, obviously not as big as the proper M4 side skirts. And we'll move over to the front. There's the side fins, which are also included in the M4 kit. And that's the mean aggressive look to the front. So yeah. So we'll talk a bit about the engine. It's a petrol, 2 litre. And it's 185 horsepower, which isn't that fast, I guess, but it's a very, very nice car, you know. Definitely a mean, aggressive look about it. Yeah, so we'll put the keys here. Nice, quite blue key. Be nice, we'll unlock it, and we'll start at the passenger seat side. So it is the coupe, so it's only a 2-door. And then you got M Sport again there. Good thing earlier. So we'll hop in. Alright, so this is us in. The M Sport. The M Sport, jeez, put someone talking about the M 4 Series, sorry. With the M Sport kit. And then again you've got the M Sport sign there and the M Sport there. That's it, just there. So it is not an automatic, it is manual. And then you've got the small mini TV screen here. It's Bluetooth as well, so you can connect your phone. Mini glove box here. Tell you all about the new BMs and stuff. What's out? So it's heated seats, you know. Decent stereo system. It's not like Bose or anything, but it's normal stereo system. And then it's coupe, so it's not got as much space as the saloon does. I'll show you back here. I'll hop out for a second, put the seats down. Yes, that's the seat down there. We'll hop in. Man. Yeah, so this me in the back, I've got a decent amount of room. And I'm 5'8", so yeah. Flip it around. And you just got the essentials. Drinks in there, flip that back up, and what was also handy, and what also they didn't have in the M3, or the 3 Series, is I'll just pop up the boot, there you go, look back here, and there's a little lever you pull, which is here, and it popped, and so you reach back. And you can push seat down. Same for these seats. Push these seats down. And you've got even more room to fit your luggage in. So, and for the seats up, you can actually fit golf clubs in, which is handy. So I'm just gonna shove the seats back up. Go around the other side. And that's up. That's that. I'm gonna shut the door and sit in the driver's seat now. Right, let's hop in. And then, what's also quite cool is when you shut the door, I'll do it again actually, that folds away, and then you shut the door. Wait, my bad. That hands the seatbelt to you. Then you click seatbelt on, and you start this bad boy up. Fortunately, my dad won't let me start it up today because it is a new car. You know, he just got it today. It's got 26 miles on it, which is quite impressive. Since this Chevrolet over here has 46,000 miles. Massive dent in the back. We need to get rid of that. Luckily, next year we're getting an M Sport X5, which is good. The brand new one in July, so it's quite a while away, but we've got this car to do us until then. So you just got the centros, you know, along here, the buttons to control the little mini TV screen here. I don't see you really know. I don't need to talk through all the auto and the car lock and all that crap, because you know really what you're doing with that. And you got two cup holders here. That's in here. You put your phone, cigarette thing. Reasonable size glove box. Store stuff down here. Pop the hood there. And you can see the start in the hood. But man, it does feel beauty to drive. Oh man, I can't wait until I hit, 25 and I can afford a car like this. I really do love this car though. Oh, what they have changed in the new cars is the size of the steering wheel is smaller. I think it's really nice. I think it's a really good touch to the car. Obviously it isn't the fastest car in the world, but one of the nicest my dad's had. He's had a turbo, but I can't remember. I was about 8 when he had that, so I can't really remember much. Yeah. So that's about it, really.